With hundreds of billions of dollars of foreign currency reserves now in the hands of developing countries such as China, Russia, India, and Brazil, what is the outlook for the U.S. markets and American investors? Well, few are better positioned to give us a comprehensive global view than our first guest. He is an economist, investment banker, and former diplomat. He is Robert Hormats, vice chairman of Goldman Sachs International, and one of Wall Street's most astute observers of the financial and political scene. He is also the author of several books. His latest is the very timely, The Price of Liberty, Paying for America's Wars. And the world's new and changing wealth is having a big impact on another high-profile market, the art market. Our next guest is experiencing that firsthand. He is Hugo Weihe. He is International Director of Asian Art at Christie's, the global auction house where he specializes in Indian and Southeast Asian art. And our third guest is going to try to protect you from another type of wealth transfer from you to Uncle Sam. The tax man will soon calleth, and joining us with some money-saving tips is Tom Herman, the Wall Street Journal's widely followed tax columnist. Great to have you all here. So thanks very much for joining us on WealthTrack. Bob, let me start out with you. How significant is this transfer of cash that I was talking about from the developed world to some key developing countries?
It's enormously significant. It's significant in two respects. One, just the magnitudes that you described are enormous compared to anything we've seen historically ever. The other is this, that in the past, it's been the case that the big industrialized countries have exported capital to the emerging economies, and therefore they've been able to set the rules. In other words, if you're the exporter of capital, you're the banker to the world, you set the rules, you press countries to apply the kind of foreign investment rules that you want. You can influence the monetary system as the US and Britain did after World War II. Now these countries are bankers to the United States and to Western Europe. The Chinese, the Russians, the Saudis, many other countries in the Middle East, they're lending us money. Now they want a say in how the global financial system works, and we're very heavily dependent on their flows of capital. We've had a credit crunch in the United States of late. Without that capital coming in terms of buying treasury bills and notes and bonds and buying other kinds of investments, we would have even more of a credit crunch. So we need their capital, and they want more influence over the way the international monetary system and the international economy work.
So how might that play out, or is it starting to play out? Are they asking to change the rules?
So far, they're not, but they want us to maintain an open environment for their capital so that they can buy intermediary institutions like investments in Blackstone and others, and they also are going to want to buy equity in American companies. They're going to want to have a broader, more diversified range of investment opportunities here. And that's going to be politically very, very interesting to see how that works out. Will we have investment protectionism on our side? Will we allow it in? Under what conditions? And will they continue to have confidence in our financial markets? If our financial markets are suffering from crisis after crisis or the subprime and other kinds of issues, they may lose some confidence in our markets, as some already have because they're shifting reserves elsewhere.
Right.
And that would be very bad for our financial system and our economy. So we've got to work a lot of new things out.
I think we're going to need your diplomatic skills, Bob Hormats, and your financial skills. So let me ask you, Hugo, the fall auction at Christie's, has just ended recently. Give us a quick state of the global art, state of health of the global art markets. How did it go?
It's fantastic. We sold close to $1 billion in 2 weeks' time. That is impressionist and contemporary art. It's amazing. It's never been like this. And the market is extremely global, extremely deep. And it's really about quality and assessing great works of art properly, and the demand is enormous.
So let's talk about the demand, because we've been talking about this shift in wealth, and I mean, you're seeing it firsthand. Number one, you specialize in Asian art, and that is one of the primary sources of new wealth and of tremendous economic dynamism and power, and also. What kind of impact are you seeing from this new global wealth in the art market? Is it very evident?
Absolutely. I mean, obviously, in China and India, we have this very strong economies growing. There's a new pride of place. And with that comes an awareness for one's own culture as well and buying into it. Now, new money is typically attracted to contemporary art. And the next step is then to reflect more, to study it further, and then to think back and look back in time and look at the historic achievements of Indian art and Chinese art and buying into that. And that will happen as well, in a big way, has already.
And finally, Tom, are our taxes going to go up? I mean, I asked for forecasts for the art market and the stock markets, but what about our taxes?
Most of the people I talk to in Washington say, yes, taxes definitely are going up, but not this year or next. They expect taxes to be pushed off until after the presidential elections in 08. So in 09, the betting is that the top ordinary income tax rate, which is now 35%,
right,
will go up to somewhere around 40%. That's where it was in the Clinton administration at 39.6. They're also betting that tax rates on capital gains will probably go up. The tax rate in general on capital gains, the top rate today, is only 15, except, of course, on art, where the top rate is 28, although there are some senators who want to cut the top tax rate on art. But art is very definitely an exception to that rule. And then nobody knows what's going to happen on the estate tax. My guess is that they will raise the basic exclusion from the estate tax. It's now $2 million. It'll go up to somewhere around $3 million or $4 million. And they will lower the rate. But nobody knows what the new rate will be.